Hello guys, my name is Sub-Zero Extabyte and I'm having a fantastic day. And I hope you guys are having a fantastic day as well. And if not yet, hope you are going to have a fantastic day. But I think I know a certain way how I can make your day fantastic, and that is what we are going to do right now. Because we are going to jump in a hole today, but not just a hole. It is going to be the fastest jump race hole ever made. Well, at least I will try. Some people say failure lasts forever, pain lasts for a minute. So, we are going to have pain for a minute and try to get to the end. And otherwise we will give up and then the failure will last forever. But as you can see, my failure won't hurt forever because I just made it and I am already busy with the next temple parkour. And now I am almost at the next one of that, but I failed too. I need to try that again. But we need to try and try again. If we fail and if we don't, then we will fail forever. So never give up on things that you want to accomplish, or if it isn't possible, then well, I think you should not ruin your life thanks to that one thing. But if something is possible and you believe in yourself, go for it, my mate. But this is not a motivational video. I am not no Shia LaBeouf, so I can't make such statements. I think that is something that he still needs to keep doing, and I have no right to do such a thing as that, manly man. But while I am talking so much, I am distracting myself from the failure that I was before, but look at me now. We made it and we can do another one. I am not sure what this is, but I think you need to not touch the snow. With another game, you have some snowman people and when you touch them you blow up. And that was something like we did before. But hey, did we end up in Egypt? Well, I am not sure where we are, but this map is made from sand, so it must be something like that, and I am sure that we will amuse ourselves. But we are in Egypt, so I think that amusing ourselves is something that is probably not that hard to do. But I like that there are ladders that you need to climb, and it is actually not that difficult to get to the ends of temple parkours right here. But it is really fun to play this temple parkour. Like this next one after the ladder thing is actually much harder because you need to keep your momentum, but it is cool that the first block is a slime block and you bounce off of the block and it is cool and you gain a lot of height, and that is something that you just need to have because otherwise you would not be able to make it. But I can't seem to make it either, so this is not really that fun, but we need to keep trying and it will all be alright and we will make it to the end eventually, and it is cool, so we need to keep trying, and if we stop trying then we will feel the pain forever. Let's just think about that, and just like that we made it, and now we need to jump some really difficult jumps, but we almost made it first try. We just missed this last block. We did not have enough speed to get on top of that last block, but that is okay because we can try again and we don't have to race a clock, and we just need to take our time and we will get there. Don't you even worry about it. Like, see, that is how easy things are, and just like that we just made it to the next stage. Oh no, it's a joke. We didn't make the very last jump, but we can once again try again, and this one was relatively easy, so it is alright, my mates. So, let's just try again, and again, and eventually we will get there. But I don't understand why I am failing at this one, because this one is actually pretty easy, but I don't have enough momentum on the very last jump. Or maybe I am just afraid to touch the cactus and hurt myself, and that I am holding back so I won't get hurt, but I don't know. We will get there, I am not even worried about that. With great skill comes great responsibility, and I do not yet have a lot of responsibility, so let's just keep trying, and that we are going to get there and then it will be alright. And just like that we made it, and it looks like we need to jump on top of cacti and then we are done. Oh no, we are now inside of the Grand Canyon or something. Why is it this orange? I am not sure, but it seems like the guy who made this really stepped his game up with this one, because look at it. You need to jump on top of a fence on top of glass panels, and I can't even reach the first jump, so I think I am going to struggle with this one right here, guys. But that is okay because I made it to the well, then never mind, but I'll be there once again. But I am starting to get hungry. So maybe I can think to myself that if I make this temple parkour, then by the end there will be a juicy burger waiting for me to eat it. And it would be served on a plate with all kinds of things that are delicious, and there will be waffles and there will be chicken and cupcakes, and it will have some spaghetti and all the things that I like. And when I get there, I am sure that I will be full after one plate, and then I will cry because then there are so many things that I like to eat, but I am not hungry anymore because I have a little stomach, and then I will cry because all of the nice things are going to the garbage can, and then I will be sad and I will be even less happy than I was a minute ago when I was still stuck at that one temple parkour. Just like I am at the moment, But I think that this one is a bit easier than the previous one though, so I think that I will be alright with this one, and I will get to the end without too much hassle just like I just did, but this one looks a bit difficult though, so I am not sure how I will react to this one. And look at the heights. If you are afraid of heights, then I don't think this one is for you. You might want to skip this one and just fly to the next one. But we will keep trying, and I think that in a couple of seconds we would be done with this glass panel thing. Well, that wasn't. Oh, my, I didn't make it. Well, now I am pretty mad. Let's cheat just a little bit. Well, it is not really cheating. Well, it actually is, but let's just not call it cheating, but let's call it making it easier for yourself. I have removed a couple of blocks, so if I make it to the orange wheel bit, then I have basically made it to the end, and then it will be alright and we are safe and sound. But if we don't, then we have to keep trying. But look at this, I made it to the end, and if I did not remove those three blocks, then I would have fallen. But it seems like these last two ones were time based. But those were the easiest ones. And what am I going to do, no, you might ask. Well, I am not really sure yet, but I have one yellow wool block as a reward, so I guess that we maybe could use that to cheat in the... Oh wait, no, we need to call it making it easier for yourself. But as I said, that this looks like one hell of a difficult temple parkour. And we are no longer in adventure mode, but we are in survival mode, so we also need to watch our health and that we don't die, because we don't want to die. Do we? Well, at least I don't want to, so I am not going to. I am going to nail the poop out of this temple parkour right here, right now. You can come with your Facebook Live and film this entire thing if you want. It is also going up on YouTube, so let's just watch it on YouTube, because in my personal opinion I like that more. But if I don't talk that much as I am doing right now, I could maybe focus a bit more on making these jumps. But that would not be fun for you guys, and I do everything for you guys, you know that, so I am going to challenge myself even more, and I am going to try to make it to the end while I am talking this entire time. And what do we have here then? I did not understand it at first, but I think that these orange blocks are there to guide me, that I have to jump on top of them, but they are invisible or something. So, I need to jump onto those, and I need to try and not fall, even though I can't even see the block that is beneath me. And we just need to try it again, and it is relatively easy once you understand what is going on, but I am trying to do it too fast, and that is why I am failing all the time. So actually I need to take my time, but I don't want you guys to get bored out, so I am still trying to do it fast as I am Sonic the Hedgehog. And when I am Sonic, then I think that if I do it just right, it will all be okay, and I will make it to the end without too much trouble, and it won't be that hard, and I will be okay when I get to the end just like I was now. And now I need to jump on the pressure plate, and just like that I am in a golden world all of a sudden. Like a minute ago I was still struggling with the diamond one, and look at me now, I am nailing this temple parkour like I did it before, and I think that this is once again amazing that we have to find a ladder or something. But I think that also this is going to be okay. And just like that, in the middle of Justin's performance, his guitar broke. Chip had to go get a new one. Chip can't drive yet because he doesn't have his driving license yet. So he had to take an Uber to the nearest guitar shop in town. But they were in Germany, and our little buddy did not speak any German at all, so he had to instruct the driver that he is the uncle of Justin Bieber. Little did the Uber driver know who Justin Bieber's uncle was, so Chip whipped out some pictures he took when Justin was just a little boy. The driver then proceeded to drive a bit faster because Justin was in the middle of a show with thousands of people waiting for him to sing. Justin nervously told some jokes that were not funny at all. The fans were impatient and started throwing some tomatoes at the poor boy. He was getting sad, and right on that moment, I fell into the water. Help, help, I can't swim. But wait, I do know how to swim? How could that be? I guess we will never know the answer of that. We should really go to the barber to get that hot mix of hairs that Charlie has on his big head. We should be twins, me and Charlie, just like Dwayne Johnson and The Rock are. Wait a second, this is not the hair shop. This is an adoption center. I do not think me and Charlie are that far into a relationship yet. We only met for 10 minutes now. There it is, the hair shop. Let's go get some change on our head. I said my hair looked perfect in the morning, but I do not think it is even close to the hair that Charlie has. The man is magnificent. Here it is already. Let's take it. Hold on. Let's take it again. Whoops, that was not on purpose, I swear. Oh god guys, it is actually a lot harder than it may look like. I am really trying. So now that is out of the way, What do we have left? Oh, that is right, we could match faces with this handsome man named Charlie. I do not really know where the face shop is, but we'll get there eventually. If you want to truly look beautiful, you have to take some pain. We are going to have a different face in a minute. I am really excited right now. Oh boy, I think that is it. The face shop. I know exactly which face I am going to take. Isn't that right, Charlie? We don't want to be rude now. Chip, do you want a different face as well? No? Okay then. This one time at band camp, I went to the football area and I played some football with the kids there. I wanted to catch the ball. It did not go to plan and I fell face down, hitting the hard concrete floor. I felt that for a while, but I don't feel anything right now. Hey, at least I look as handsome as Charlie. Not a lot of people can say that about themselves. Let's head home and celebrate my new great looks. I think we really accomplished something today. What started off as a high-speed chase with Usain Bolt speeds now ended in a true friendship between the three amigos. But not really. And all of a sudden saw some guy that looked like Steve who had a mushroom cow on a leash. And at first, I was like, what is this then? We aren't on a mushroom island. And he was just chilling with a cow. And I was like, how does that cow get up the hills that he is taking her on? Wait, cows are females, right? Yeah, I think so. Bulls are the male version of cows. Or am I just not a biologist today? I don't know, but I believe that this is the case. So, I was basically really amazed when I saw the guy with the cow, since I haven't told you guys that I was with a sheep on the mountain yet, and my sheep was called Bang Bang. Why Bang Bang? Well, because she is actually really good at shooting the bow and arrow. So I took her to a range one day. Wait, no, I need to finish this story first. So me and Bang Ben were just having a nice campfire up in the mountains. And that is when me and Betsy saw that cow. I am not sure what his name was at that time, but we just called it the cow, as it is a cow. But anyways, me and Bang Bang then abandoned the still ongoing campfire to have a little word to the cow shepherd. I am not sure if the cow herder, oh, it is a cow herder, right? Not a cow shepherd. Yeah, thanks. And we were talking to the man, a really kind man by the way. He told me that he lived on an island and the rest I kind of forgot already. So he was living a pretty happy life on the island, but he wanted to chill with more homies since he was kind of lonely on the island. I explained the situation to Bang Bang, and we were happy to help. I could not swim yet, so I had to build a boat or something to get to his island, but Steve offered me to hop on very big boat because he had a very big boat. Me and Bang Bang, the crazy bow and arrow hero, didn't have to swim. He told us that on some day he fed so many mushrooms to his cow that she turned into a mushroom and he could not sink because the mushrooms are very light. So that was very nice because then his cow was basically also a life vest. So he didn't need to buy that. I then hopped on his boat and Bang Bang followed. She was made out of wool and stuff, so it was kind of amazing to chill with her on a boat. And no, my sheep wasn't able to talk by the way. Anyways, we had to swim a while. This guy, he didn't have enough power to pedal anymore. And I was kind of too lazy. As I already told you guys, I don't like to get tired. That is why if I would be a tour guide, I would buy a jeep for you guys, because the island was pretty far from the boat. We did have to swim. We could just chill on his cow her back, so that was cool. No life vest needed. Bang Bang was still behind us and made sheep noises, and I could kind of understand her in some weird way, and she was trying to say that she could see land already. I hopped on the mushroom her back, and from that point on we could not see Steve anymore. It was a very sad moment for both of us. But then we were talking about it during the swim to his island. Betsy said she saw a guy with goggles underneath us, so we didn't actually lose Steve. No need to be sad anymore. Then we were already kind of close to the island, and the island was just amazing. So, you see where we are right now on this top of this mountain? Well, that was kind of like his island. Only then his mountain, which speaks for itself, was on an island, so it was kind of cooler. He had like two mountains connected to each other, but they weren't really connected, so he had this really amazing bridge. And he had this really amazing glass modern house on top of these two mountains. Then he also had a barn for his one cow that he brought everywhere. And that was my little story about Steve the main man. I don't know why I told that story again, but I just was in the mood to tell a story for once. So, I did, and it was a banger of a story. But don't you guys think that this mod is just the best? There are flying islands. That would be even cooler than Steve. If I had him on my phone, then I would totally build a really amazing house on one of those islands. But sadly I don't have his number or anything. That means that I can't send the man a text with a photo. That is kind of sad, isn't it? Yes, indeed. think that is very sad. I am out here in the woods though. This is so beautiful that I am getting kind of sad, and not really because it is beautiful but because the video is coming to its end. I am not sure why I came here. I will probably destroy this lab after the video is done because yay, it freaks me out. That is one thing. The other is that, well, there is no other, so. Wait, maybe Chip would like to have this lab. He is always down for these kind of things. I wonder why I didn't ask him to come. Well, I will call him in and show it to him. No worries, pranksters. But people, I am going to end the video now. Don't worry, I will be back soon. Sooner than you think, with a new video and new content. So for now, bye.